Blackstone presents Halifax, Transgression by Roger Simpson. This book is read by Aimee Horne.
Dedication for Sally. Chapter 1.
Hello, Jane. It's Eric Ringer.
Jane stood with her mobile held to her ear.
You probably don't remember me.
She remembered him very well.
It's probably been 20 years.
It had been 23.
We worked together on the Point Cook shooting.
How could anyone fail to remember that?
Hello, Eric, she said at last. I must admit you were the last person I expected to phone, especially at 8:30 on a Friday night. Are you still in Canberra?
No. I came back to be closer to the family. I was happy with the federal police, but this COVID thing made travel too hard, and with the ex and the kids still in Melbourne, I'm back with Victoria Police again, as head of homicide.
So how can I help you, Eric?
Work, I'm afraid.
Don't apologise for that.
This one you probably won't thank me for.
Which seemed a strange thing for a policeman to say.
I'm at the crime scene now, if you're interested, and available. It's one you should see for yourself. I don't usually say this, but I genuinely don't know where to start.
Something I won't thank you for, she said, her imagination already racing. She was at the same time attracted and repelled by the invitation.
I won't even begin to describe it. If you can come, I'll send a car.
Jane hung up the phone and got herself ready. A tailored jacket and a plain white shirt, never overdressed for work. She had the lift to herself as she descended from her apartment on the 7th floor. A police car was already waiting outside. Apart from the usual greetings and talk about the weather, she barely spoke to the female constable for the 20 minutes it took to drive to Toorak, nor did she ask anything about the case. Ringer seemed to think it important that she assessed the crime scene, though photographs or first-person accounts usually sufficed. Did she really have to see this for herself? The memories of the Point Cook shooting came flooding back, the mass killing that had more to do with counselling survivors than solving the crime, though they managed to do that too. It was the first time she and Ringer had met. He, a newly minted detective who looked like Hugh Jackman, she only a few years older and comparatively new to forensic psychiatry. She remembered too the New Year's Eve they had spent together, an unexpected digression from the pressures of that particularly distressing case, a sweet moment in time when they both were young and single. Would he remember it as fondly as she? Opening the presents under the Christmas tree, her magic trick with the champagne, her apartment high above the city, a less luxurious version of the one she had now. The police car wound around the river and turned up St. George's Road, the houses becoming more opulent as the better-heeled burghers of Melbourne displayed the elegance and acreage their wealth allowed. Police vehicles outside the crime scene announced they had arrived at their destination. In any other suburb, crowds of onlookers would have assembled by now, but not in Toorak. It's not becoming for the rich to stand and stare. Jane signed herself in at the gate. The mansion and its expansive gardens were illuminated by a battery of arc lights. She was handed gloves and plastic overboots and told to stick to the laneway marked by police tape that snaked across the lawn as the driveway was still being checked by forensics. As she approached the house, Ringer was waiting to greet her.
Hello, Jane.
Hello, Eric. It was good to see him, and see that he still looked like Hugh Jackman. At 53 and 57, they'd both aged very well. He didn't have the spread of the usual policeman, nor she any signs she'd surrendered to middle age. She supposed he could credit his exercise regime, she her mother's genes. It was hard not to relive their original meeting all those years ago. Jane had prepared for the dead bodies the Point Cook killer had left in his wake, apart from the last one. The one she'd stumbled upon as she'd pushed through a side door in search of fresh air, heeding too late Ringer's warning to look away. You can attend pathology classes over years of university, but you can't unsee.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.